This is Manchester. By day, it's run by police. By night, it's run by gangsters. Manchester is where I was born, where I live, and where I'll die.
Give a frig about what them fools think. Frig your network, our network will speak for itself. Proof of the trophy and the champion belt. Come sun, come rain, come hailstone pelt. Witness the fitness.
Dominic Latley Fotfoy is one of Manchester's most notorious gangsters. He's over 40 convictions for armed robbery, police assault, attacks on prison officers, deception, firearms, prison escape, and fraud. He has been charged with prison riot, conspiracy to import drugs, kidnapping, extortion, witness intimidation, and has been implicated in, though never convicted, of a number of gangland murders.
When I was doing the assay in the door, it was a tough door. The different gangs, Moss Side, TMO, Salford, all turning up, all wanting to come in for nothing. So me and this other lad that were on the door, said enough was enough, let's take the trouble to them. And we did. Took it to them. What?
Tell me the story.
The Dog's Head. That was the nickname for the pub after that. Everyone used to say, I'll meet you down at the Dog's Head. We just went to the pub. He had a shotgun on him. And they had a machete. And one of the gang lads' dog was about, so I just chopped its head off and carried it inside the pub and put it on the pool table. And more or less told them and asked them to stay away from the hacienda, or the next time it'd be a humanoid. And they never came back. Dominic James Latley Fotfoy the first. Many years ago, my dad used to say to me, just look after those that look after you. Fuck off those that fuck off you. So I changed it by that name. So that they fought for, that's what the initials stand for.
Dominic is a member of the infamous Noonans, a well-known criminal family. He changed his name by deed poll in prison, where he has spent 22 of his 39 years.
Dominic, this is home.
These are all my kids. These are my nephews, godsons and cousins. No one else will have them.
Dominic has two children of his own by different mothers.
You see the size of my fish tank? They're expensive. See them? They're very, very expensive, them. This is Aidan, my godson.
Got his head flushed before, didn't you, mate?
Bugsy, my son.
Bugsy. And Bugsy, who's your mum?
Manda.
Andy. I love the kids coming around. It reminds me of my little days when I was a kid.
It's the same madhouse that you had growing up.
Yeah, it was mad. We'd all bring our own friends home, so you can imagine there'd be 40, 50 people in the house. There'd be upstairs and everywhere. When the house went on fire, the whole lot went through all the ceiling, right up to the top. So when you walked in, you could see right to the top. Yeah. Is that my vest there? It's dirty now, look, they just stamped all over it.
So has it ever been used in anger?
I wear it when I'm on meetings. Or when I go out with my mum's for dinner.
When you were doing the armed robberies, would you use the...
I would put one on, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, I always wore one. But I don't do those things no more. I've set up my own security firm, Hunter Security. A flourishing business.
Dominic made his reputation by hijacking cash-laden security vans and has added one to his private vehicle collection.
Does that need a new wheel on it or what? Does that need pumping up or a new wheel?
I must admit, it is my favourite vehicle of all vehicles. I'd have that one. The bus, the taxis, forget about that. That's my favourite vehicle. It brings back memories.
Are you still up for business?
If the right job come along, yeah.
And have you been asked?
I've been asked by many teams.
Yeah.
But I've knocked them back.
Yeah.
It's just not right money, or I didn't like it. It's a pity, really, because one of them I was offered on there, we got a lot of money out of it.
Did they?
And I was devastated after this.
You missed your chance.
I did.
And every time you pass one of these vehicles on the road, you get a bit of a...
get an hard on.
Do you?
I actually get an hard on.
Lock the door and throw away the keys. Blow out the candles.
morning's moving in. Flowers bloom on.
Dominic spent over 22 years in 27 prisons across Britain. He led a violent campaign against prison officers and was one of the architects of the Strange Ways riot.
Prisoners from the sprawling slums are a new day moving in. No baton charge from the ruling guards can stop a cage bird singing.
So blow out the candles, morning's moving in. Flowers bloom on Alcatraz now.
Two dead and nearly 200 wounded. The prison revolt cost more than £50 million.
Are you proud of your work with the Prison Liberation Army?
I was, yeah. I was made up. Now we've got our own back on them. A sense of justice.
The death in August 2003 in a motorcycle accident of their younger brother Damien, a gangland peacekeeper and enforcer, brought the family's respect and power to public attention. Large parts of northwest Manchester were brought to a standstill for the funeral. 10 police riot vans supervised the wake. 100 policemen blocked the roads for the cortege. Greater Manchester Police asked the family to contribute to the cost of the operation. The Noonans refused. Dominic Noonan, a.k.a. Mr. Latley Fotfoy, has taken over from his brother as the head of one of Manchester's most powerful crime families. The Noonans, 14 of them, were brought up in a two-bedroom house close to the cemetery. Their mother burnt their house down in an effort to move up the housing list. As children, they stole the fences and garden sheds of neighbours for firewood.
Have you seen them lights light up at night? You've not seen them? Have you seen them? They're thingy, aren't they? Solar power. And they light up and they flicker.
Fucking drives too fast, keep telling him, slow it down, man.
Loads of armed robbers in Moston. Pull over there, under that. Pull over under that. That there, that van there, you see it?
Yeah.
That video's all the fucking security vans around there. He'll sit there, there's a security van due any second now to this bank here. There it is, look, bang on time. Now he goes into the back, his mate gets out. He's got a vest on him, he has, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Got a bulletproof vest on him, I've never seen that one before. Oh, yeah, they'd drop off £500,000 in that bank.
If you were on the job, what would you do?
What, on that one now?
Yeah.
I'd park up there in the van, and as he comes out, I'd burst out the door and grab him.
What would you say to him?
Follow me, over here now. You, open the fucking door, throw the bags out now, start throwing them out, quick. You know, do it. Throw the fucking bags out now! Gets it! Police chase can sometimes be scary or buzz. Depends what's after you, what's behind you. Yeah. And why they're chasing you. Yeah. If you're coming off a job, then you're more worried. If you've gone out deliberate and look for the chase, it's a buzz.
So would you go out and deliberately create a chase, provoke a chase?
Many years ago, yeah.
Tell me about that.
Yeah, here's the police now. So we take one now if you want. Watch your shirt to take a fucking chase, Dad, or watch.
That's not.
Are you sure?
Yeah, thanks.
All right, then.
11 years ago, the police were chasing Dominic all over Britain when they suspected he'd arranged his own escape from custody in order to go on a robbery spree.
Police in Manchester say they're baffled by the apparent kidnapping of a remand prisoner. As John Molson reports, they're not sure whether he's been abducted or whether it was part of an elaborate escape.
You broke out from a prison van to rob a security van.
We had two security vans to rob the same day. One in the morning around about 10 o'clock, one at 4 o'clock. We was going for the double, no one's ever done a double before. So we just thought we'll have a laugh.
Two masked men run up to the car at these lights. One had a hammer, the other a gun. They threatened the prison officers and forced them to release Noonan. In the struggle, the gun was fired, but no one was hurt. Noonan was bundled into the back of a waiting car. Police say they're now afraid for his safety, if he's been abducted.
What was the reaction of the prison officers?
He admitted in court that he pissed his pants. He said, "I just pissed my pants in the back of the car." I could hear him pissing anyway. And when I remember saying to him, "Don't let him take me, don't take the cuffs off." And he said, I can't stop him. Because they had the gun pressed against him, saying, "Take the cuffs off." "Oi, shh, fuck off, quick. Set the dog on you. You can see this film, so shut your fucking mouth and fuck off. Now." Fucking mong. Sorry.
He only managed one armed robbery and was back in prison within 5 days. Despite the kidnapping ruse, he was convicted and sentenced to another 14 years.
Today.
How many have you had in?
Too many kids going back to school. How's Damien's kids?
They're all right.
Yeah.
About 8 months, 9 months.
Yeah.
Shocked everyone, wasn't it?
I couldn't believe it, but I found out. Devastated. Devastated.
Did you go?
I went to the funeral, yeah, but there's so many in the church, I couldn't get anywhere near it.
No.
So, Andy, what are you getting done today?
Extensions.
You think a uniform commands respect?
Yeah, it does. And then it gives respect back.
And your boys really kind of have a uniform, don't they? Always wearing, looking pretty sharp and wearing ties and...
It's important to us, look good. And we know we're being watched all the time, so we want to look smart, especially in case we end up in front of a jury.
How much money do you think has gone to the hands of the Noonans over the last 20 years?
Allegedly made over 5 to 6 million. But where's the money?
That's the question I'm asking. Where's the money? Is it in property? Is it in horses?
No, it's behind the bar in landlords' pubs.
So with all the money you've made, you're still making money, you're still active. Is that the message you're still going out?
I'm still dangerous. Anyone's dangerous. But there's some that are really dangerous.
And you're really dangerous?
Yeah.
And the next generation is ready and waiting?
Yeah, we're already primed.
So how many's in your crew?
There's about 20, but I always keep the young ones around me because they're more loyal, more trustworthy. And got a lot of respect for them, and they've got a lot of respect for me. I know that they will watch my back, and I'll have to respect them and watch their back. And they know I've had their backs many times for them, because I know that they will die for me and I'll die for them. They'll shoot for me and I'll shoot for them.
Hit the dance around about midnight. A gin and juice and he's a feeling fine. I come on and all sounds went up. Police, a man said the joint was shut.
Dominic has been arrested by 30 armed police after hours of surveillance.
Where's Adam and Michael? I don't know where Dominic is.
Right there, nobody knows what's happened. All we know is the police have arrested Dominic in a major move by the armed response unit. Now, when he was with us 5 minutes previously, Dominic was armed with little more than a bottle of Bex. But I doubt if the police arrested him without good reason.
Don't take me for some little dickhead. I was getting ripped off for fuck all, so don't take me for some dick.
Yeah, you shouting nearly got me, don't you? I'm shouting at you, yeah, I nearly got myself arrested. We talked to give you an information, yeah? Give me information, shut your fucking mouth.
I fucking give my information, you weren't getting grabbed. Don't you little knobhead, so shut your fucking mouth.
How long you gotta wait until you get the keys to the mansion owner?
They said they'll be out Monday now.
They've taken the car, have they?
No, we've got to get out of the van now.
That's okay. Been clamped, sorry to
it's
tell
not.
You.
It has. It's not.
Jamie,
Dom
what
said
did
it
Dom
might
say?
Be. He said, Steve said they're clamping through the day.
Dominic was picked up Saturday lunchtime, and with the courts closed, won't be released until Monday, if at all.
Can't do it right here, can you?
No, well, go on, just do one anyway.
I was walking up the road here to collect the car, to collect the van, and an Audi's pulled up, now an Audi Estate's just pulled up, skidded, jumped out, so no one knew you stand against
freeze,
the wall,
freeze,
put your hands up, let me see your hands and all that.
So why were you two guys fighting?
Well, that was just a little silly argument blown out of
proportion. Why? Because the police were like, ah, he's giving the police loads, yeah? And I'm just trying to calm down, saying, look, the more you shout, yeah, the more you're just going to get yourself up. They'll just arrest you. I mean, they'll just say, look, sunshine, throwing the back of the van and he's riding with fucking.
But there's a way of doing it and there's a way of explaining things to people, and poking somebody in the face in a public place just pissed me off.
Andy, how do you feel about being the boss?
Oh, God,
I'm not the boss, me and him are the oldest.
Yeah.
Simple as.
And we're the younger brothers of the family. Young Offenders Institute.
And how old are you now?
17.
You're 17. So if you weren't working for Dom, what would you be doing?
Acting.
Right. So who are you acting for?
I've done things for Red Productions, Love in the 21st Century. I've done adverts with Roy Keane and David Beckham.
Really?
I've tried getting him in, but he won't get off his arse and get it into gear 4 and do his lines.
Whoa, why do I need to sit and stand and just speak a load of bullshit into a camera? I've got better things to do with my time.
You'd make more money from acting than you would from criminality.
No, I won't say that.
Oh, no. I'm not a criminal.
Okay.
You're just assuming I'm a criminal. I'm not.
But you're part of the crew. Are you part of the crew? Part of Dominic's crew.
Dominic's. I'm not saying I'm part of his crew. I'm friends with Dominic, do you know what I mean? He's looked after me.
You clearly get respect when you go.
Oh, yeah, you do. Everywhere he's gone, everywhere we've been with him, innit? They always, everyone shakes your hand everywhere you go. I suppose you get a bit of a big head standing next to him and all that. He's genuine, man. He's proper caring person. He's top.
Do you think there'll ever be a day when one of you guys are going to turn grass on the other? Because every criminal gang always has a grass in it.
Well, I'm lucky for those that do then, innit?
Dominic Noonan, facing a range of charges, including kidnap and extortion, has been arrested for breach of bail. He was released on Monday morning.
I was kept in the cell Saturday night and Sunday night. No visits, no phone calls, no letters, no mails, no newspapers to read. Not even a change of clothing was allowed to be handed in. Other prisoners got that, but not me, of course.
Dominic Noonan convinced the court that he wasn't at fault. Unable to convict Dominic for his major crimes, the police pull him in on minor ones. They claim that Dominic's London cab isn't properly taxed. 12 police vehicles have come to take it away.
You know what, for police harassment of DJ Noonan security, you know the vehicles, you know they're all insured, you know they're all taxed. Bye!
Do you ever think of going straight?
Thought about it many times, but sometimes it's difficult. I mean, trying to set up a security firm, but the police won't let us go straight. It's the way the police is around here in Manchester.
Yeah, but going straight is a kind of personal decision, isn't it? You could go straight. You choose not to.
No, you can go straight, but there's just that we got that name, we got that reputation. The reputation goes before the name.
But you made that reputation along with your brothers.
Maybe so, but at the end of the day, we don't really want to keep that reputation. It's just stuck with us. Stuck with us through generations of uncles as well. And now our nephews are going to suffer the same. As we get older, they'll suffer the same.
So do you think you were always destined to be a criminal and you were always destined to continue that work and not go straight?
You never know what's around the corner. You never know what might win the lottery.
I've got fucking loads of stuff that I fucking need to sell, but no one's got any fucking money.
Well, just talk to them, just tell them the story, and then we'll go and talk to the other fella and fucking get the payments down.
Yeah, I can get 500 for tomorrow morning.
All right, I'll give you a call in about an hour, I'll let you know what's happening.
All right, cheers, Dom.
All right, ta-da. All right. This guy fucking got himself into some serious trouble. He's gone to some fucking really heavy gangster. He's got himself into some serious fucking debt. He's offered the guy $9,000 for a $2,000 fucking loan. The fucking knob.
Mick got himself into debt to a London gangster and found himself being threatened to pay up or else. In desperation, he robbed a corner post office, armed with a towel wrapped around his forefinger. He called upon Dominic for help.
Just for the record, what made you possess you to go into a post office with no weapon and expect to walk out?
Fucking stupidity, I think. I walked in, put the bag in the through the tray. Said, put the money in the bag and don't do anything stupid. He went, what? So I repeated myself. He went, fuck off. Pushed the button. I was like, fuck. I've seen it on TV where the fucking
shutters
come down and the shutters come down. I thought, oh, fucking hell, I'm well stuck here. No. I turned round, looked at the door, it was still like slightly open. I just fucking ran for the door. I was bumped in my car and I was gone.
Was the alarm ringing?
Oh, fuck yeah, that's loud, that. That was loud, that. I remember that fucking sound. I remember that song forever. It was fucking horrible.
So how were you caught?
I did it in my own fucking car. My own car. No fucking false reg plates on it. And I parked the fucking thing outside.
And you're coming up for trial shortly. That'll be a plead guilty, I suppose.
Can't fucking deny it, can I, really?
What to charge you with?
Attempted robbery. Attempted robbery.
Without firearms, though?
Without firearms.
Didn't you have any CCTV?
No.
You couldn't really prove it was you, then?
I've admitted it, no.
You shouldn't have said anything,
not comment. I've admitted it, no. Nothing I can do about it. The only reason that I went in there was through fear. Like, I've got to get this fucking money, I've got to get my time running out. It was like, I had to do what I had to do.
There's a lot of people, you know, with deaths like you, you know, who are struggling.
How did I get out of it? How did I get out of it? That's what I want. How did I get out of it? It's not nice owing all this money. But it's got to be a way out. Do you want to buy some carpet?
Today is gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Backbeat, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you've heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do.
All the fish have died out of that fish tank.
Worse than your driving, Andy.
I know. Hey, no one beats my driving, cunt.
You fuck off. No, you're pissing me off now. Oi, you're pissing me off. Move out of the way, will you? Just keep your fucking noise down, or you'll be moving. Shut up. Shut up, I'll send someone out to beat you up in a minute. I will. This is my man over here. In daytime, I act as a social worker. Everyone seems to come to me with their problems around this area and other areas outside Manchester too. And it's one of them deprived areas. I was born here and bred here, and this is where I want to stay.
Fuck you, no. It's a fucking safari. This is a rough area.
They're knocking them all down. This is history, this. And they're just gonna take it away.
I'm going to a lady's house who just phoned me to say that her husband has been tapped with an hammer. And the guy who's done it is also threatened to burn the house down. With the kids in it.
This one. What's it called?
Bailiffs, open up.
Sure this is their street?
Yeah.
I like Tom.
Instead of going to the police, many in the community here rely upon gangsters like Dominic to solve their social problems.
You like Steve?
He bit my arm and he twisted it and tried to snap it. Right? Then she comes screaming like a banshee. Blah, did blah, said whatever. Do you know what I mean? He's come with an hammer to the front door, cracked him with the hammer.
Really? Yeah. Yeah. Who fucking killed you, that blow to the head?
then threatened to torch the house with the kids.
What do you want me to do?
I don't know, have a word or...
I'll just basically tell them to stay away.
Yeah.
Can you leave a message after the call?
Dominic promised to sort the man out and was rewarded with breakfast.
Let's take a wander through town, show you all the places around.
Even a row over loud music requires Dominic's attention.
Can we get some agreement on that bit? Everyone just keeps the music down to level and fucking say good morning and that's it. Can I just come back one more time and I'll monitor it for you? If there's a missing about...
Well, why did I leave my house? I might have been here 10 years. Can you answer me that?
Yeah.
A 16-year-old boy is being threatened and the family call in Dominic. Warnings were issued and the threat stopped.
Woodfort to remove a baby that was taken away but from the mother by the grandparents.
Rachel has been trying to get her young daughter back for over a week.
Get me on it, take it away.
Rachel's parents refuse to return their granddaughter while Rachel continues her relationship with her traveller boyfriend. The police and Dominic are called in to return the child.
Right, we just take that fucking baby out.
But you left her arrested then, wasn't it? Because we're not letting you be brought until my dad says goodbye to her. I know around here everybody knows me. Mummy, you brought my word away.
You are there. Backseat.
Please.
Put that fucking cigarette out of your fucking mouth. Fucking prick.
Oh, let's go. Move out.
You've caused some problems tonight, haven't you? Hey?
Yeah.
Things got fucking lost, if you ask me. They're looking for strange ways, aren't they?
Is that a prison van?
Yeah, that's a prison van, that. Let the prisoners go! Let the prisoners go! Let the prisoners go!
The Noonans, in great gangster tradition, support the local boxing club.
I've always thought, I hope you don't mind me asking you this, that there's a hint of lavender about you, Dominic.
Lavender? What makes you think that? Because I've got a bald head.
Put it another way, you know, are you gay?
Yeah, of course I'm gay. Everyone knows I'm gay.
Do they?
Well, everyone around me knows I'm gay.
Yeah.
My family know. Brothers and sisters. Best mates.
How did you first become aware that you were gay?
When I was first aware of it, I think it was just messing about in an empty house with some of my mates. And then I carried it on from there, because I'd already experienced it. I went to a boarding school just the day after my birthday, and I was 13 then, exactly 13, and I was sat in the bedroom upstairs in the dorm. And then the night time come, I sat on the bed and just got punched straight in the face. I saw a white flash in that. I got told you to do what we tell you to do. Told me to take my clothes off, start playing with them. dropping them off. And then they raped me, about six of them. And it went on all night. It went on for weeks, every night. And they'd take turns with me staying in the bed all night, two at a time, rape me. And then they just went the next one, the next one, the next one. They just went on and on and on, laughing and joking, and making me do dirty things. I wouldn't want to wish on anyone. Caught up with every single one of them. I severely hurt them. I just fucking punched them or kicked them and that. But the main one, I managed to pick up. He didn't recognise me. Well, I remembered him. He got hurt as well. I met him one night in the gay village, and I dealt with him. I dealt with him severely. I really hurt him. I tortured him proper. The best quality torture you could do. Just fucking knock the fuck out of him. I did things that he wished he never did to me.
Despite his criminality, Dominic regularly visits his local Catholic church.
Dominic, you've done some terrible things. How do you manage that with being a Christian and a Catholic?
I get satisfaction coming to a church and asking for forgiveness, and I believe I've just been forgiven for what I've done. I can just walk out of here and probably do the same again and just come back here. Obviously, you can't do that. The court say I'm sorry and expect to walk away.
Do you have any consideration for the kind of victims?
I do, yeah. On quite a few, and I look back and think, should I have done that? Shouldn't have handled it a different way. And sometimes I think, no, that's what they deserved. They did it to someone else, and they get back what they've done.
Do you ever kill a man?
No.
Do you ever order a man to be killed?
I can't questions like that, can I, really? You can't answer questions like that. I'd be arrested. It's been alleged that I have. But if
you allegedly ordered the execution of a man, would you allegedly feel guilty about that?
If I was going to do something like that, that person would have to have done something really bad. Not a silly thing, it's something really, really serious. Then, yeah, I wouldn't think twice about it.
How do you sleep at night?
Laid out on my bed straight.
Since coming out of prison in 2002, after a 10-year stretch, he has styled himself a security expert and developed an unhealthy interest in uniforms, old police cars, security vans, and ambulances.
There's going to be 11 of these in the next few weeks. We're going to convert them into cash carrying vans.
These back doors will be sealed up. These are getting sealed up with steel inside it. And then we got all this coming out. I'm building cages here. One man will remain in the back of the van. One man gets out. We'll lift up the shutters, drop the money in, all out, put it down.
We're offering a cheaper service because I think security corps and Group 4 are too expensive.
Despite his long criminal record, Dominic is taking advantage of his standing in the community and opening his own community police station, offering protection, security and banking services. Many locals have already signed up for Dominic's protection and financial services, much to the distress of Greater Manchester Police.
There's 75 quid each.
It is secure because they've got to get the fencing up, yeah. It's got cameras in it. All bulletproof windows going on this side. You can't sledge through it. Same with this here. You can't come through this side. The desk go in here and they just hand the money out. There'll be little shutters on them. Put the bags out to them. There's also 5,000 safe deposit boxes going in downstairs. So you can leave all your deeds in there, your passports, anything of value. Half of them will probably put drugs and guns in them. We advise not to leave any money.
Oh, Julie, because we're not taking responsibility for it. This is my undercover unit.
What's that love for washing your windows?
Oh, nice one.
Just wash your windows. Can you give us a lift back to the background, though?
With imprisonment an occupational hazard for Dominic's crew, there's a steady turnover of young associates. Aaron leads the new breed. Dominic and his entourage have recently moved into a newly built bungalow in a secluded cul-de-sac.
So,
Mount
Generous,
while this is the only house that Dominic officially has in his name, it's understood he has many hidden stakes in nightclubs, pubs, and apartments in the northwest of England.
All this food's paid for by me, by generosity again. Are you eating that song a lot?
Apart from a security crew of young men, the key people in Dominic's daily life are his godson Paul, his nephew the singer Sean, and his son Bugsy. The Noonan family have been the scourge of Manchester police for over 30 years. Desmond Noonan, Dominic's older brother, is a serious criminal. He has a long track record as an armed robber and a reputation as a gangland executioner.
Yeah, my mates asked me to whack you, Phil.
Did they?
So, yeah.
You're not very good,
for
are you?
For the camera. Believe it or not, though, what a nice family we've got. We don't do everything nice, but you know, we do look after each other. We look after our friends. We come out at 3 or 4 in the morning. We stop all the burglars, we stop most of the filthy fucking drugs hanging about, you know what I mean?
Still seem to be very strong in Manchester.
Oh yeah, we're still strong. It's not just we're strong, we've got lots of strong people around us. It's not just that we're strong anyway, we've got lots of strong, loyal people around us. We'll always have that. You know, if they think they can just take one of us out and it's over, then they're silly fucking people. Very silly people.
As bank robbers, they have allegedly stolen over £4.5 million. Between them, the Noonan brothers have been sentenced to over 85 years in jail.
Yeah, let's do one about the prisoner's song years ago. It's called Standing Here Naked. It's about the strip souls. Standing here naked, my clothes are on the floor. Tissues since my body to most out of the door. They laugh and they stagger, the governors they poker. Your borders are to violate, there's nothing you can do. You can take me, don't treat me, and play by the game. But you'll never take my dignity, you'll never see my pain. For all you evil warders that play this evil game, it's how that stands in the kid, it's you that stands in shame. It's how that stands in the kid, it's you that stands in shame. It's how that stands in the kid, it's you that stands in shame.
On the roof, thought it was gonna be there. Well, I'm gonna prove it.
Dominic is on his way to London for another trial. He's accused of being part of a £600,000 heroin deal with a major London criminal. The prosecution claim he rode shotgun on the car that picked up the drugs, and that he arranged the final details of the deal outside this London cafe. Dominic claims he only acted as security for what he thought would be the collection of some foreign currency. Her Majesty's Customs and Excise beg to differ.
Yeah, I'm just heading into court now. Yeah, cheers. All right.
Dominic Lapley, top point, go to court number 3.
If found guilty, Dominic Noonan, a.k.a. Mr. Latley Fotfoy, will face up to 15 years in prison.
shouldn't take much longer, no.
What's happened?
Johnny's gone out for the considered verdict.
Yeah.
Sent a note in. That's my brother, Desi. That's the call. Desi, the jury's just come back in. They've been sent home by the judge, but they did send a letter in, which is encouraging. They said, is it possible to find one guilty and one not guilty on count four? Well, I'm here to give my side of the story, but the fella's not here. Kid, I'll call you back 1 minute.
So one of you, it seems, is going to be declared innocent?
Yeah.
Can't send an innocent man down. He was only picking up foreign currency.
He's only down after security.
The jury of six women and six men have been out for 4 days.
Yes! Nice one. Yeah, come, let's go.
Hold on, guys, just come out, go.
Not guilty.
Oh, what happened? Hold on.
Just come back with a not guilty verdict, which was the right verdict to come back with. At the end of the day, my solicitors and me barrister did the investigation for that case to prove my case was innocent. Nothing else, nothing short, nothing less.
What now?
I'm going to go back because I'm sorting out my expenses.
Yeah.
It's cost me a lot of money, this trial.
Only one defendant in the multi-million pound trial was convicted, but he had already skipped the country.
Where's justice? Where's justice?
Freeze! Everybody clap your hands.
Thank you for everyone coming tonight. As you know, I was on a very serious charge down in London for a charge I never knew about. I went down there as security. Someone else was picking up some drugs. I thought it was a load of money. I'm talking a load of bullshit. Who gives a fuck? enjoy yourselves. Eat the food. Don't wait for me because I've just had some chips on the way up. This is dedicated to the customs and excise.
Suspicious minds, and we can build our dreams on suspicious minds. Oh, smile, I draw the tears from your eyes, and all the good things
back on the streets, Dominic enjoys his status as a pillar of the community, sponsoring a firework party for the children on his patch.
No, no, you're gay.
Well, you've got to get your act together and do your own stuff. Yeah, you go round to the house and say, want some money for fireworks. You say, get to fuck. You say, you get to fuck, you cunts. We run this area, not you.
Despite his generosity, the people of Salford and Mostyn, his family's strongholds, are well aware that he's a dangerous racketeer and major underworld player.
Local drug dealer. Yeah.
Stop it. Don't be that baby on.
These kids have been selling drugs around there. I tell them not to sell them because they don't listen.
Nah, they're having you over, man. I don't do
this guy's the biggest drug dealer in Manchester, mate. He keeps on the deal, though, this guy.
So I'm saying, do I look like a drug dealer? Have you seen me? Come on.
They know you're lying now.
Aaron, a young associate of Dominic, is carving out his own reputation as a drug dealer and wannabe gangster.
Grass out, you, Michael. I was getting arrested, never gets charged. I wonder why.
You know what it is with him? He's known as what you call a sweet grass.
What do you mean a sweet grass?
He says things pretending like, oh, we know, but then the police get to hear about
it. Sure!
I'll say on camera, he has slept with me.
Don't chat shit, oh no!
Why have you gone red?
Why have I gone red? Because I don't want to look like a puff on national TV. That's why.
I had 12 of these cups when I first come in, I've got fucking two left.
After fathering two children, Dominic is now exclusively gay.
Fucking not watched nothing, then, little bastard.
Oi, who's at the cakes? Being serious now, fuck the camera. Who's at
me?
Who's at me cakes now? Someone has at me fingers.
I had one coconut cake.
Why?
Why?
To my cakes. You didn't ask for permission. Fucking go buy them back. Double fucking back. Oh, when did you get arrested for the breach of bail? I've been arrested for breach of bail twice. Dom got me out the first time, said you have to release him now because he tried keeping me. Illegally tried keeping me. Dom was my solicitor.
I said, are you going to get him in court tomorrow, Sunday? Don't think so.
What was the charge you're on bail for?
Assault, criminal damage.
Dominic, I could be talking to a younger version of you here.
Better looking, get it right.
I am better looking.
Dom serves and protects, we just serve.
As one of Manchester's most high-profile gangsters, Dominic Noonan surrounds himself with young men. But pride of place on the mantelpiece is reserved for Bugsy, his 11-year-old son.
It's the only picture I've got, it's of my little Bugsy. Looking sweet and innocent, but a little fucking bastard.
Little soldier, don't you know where you come from? Aren't you gonna get your king? Where have all the children gone? Long time passing winter and spring. Where have all the flowers gone? There's a guy around this way who walks the streets he needs to play. And everybody knows his name, they whisper. Little soldier, if you got nowhere to run. Little soldier, aren't you gonna get your gun? Mother warned you, but she knows you'll meet him one day down the road. Maybe he's only just around the corner. Maybe one day he'll come for you. Then what else do you need to do? Maybe you've got no option more.
Eileen Noonan, Dominic's cousin, runs an open house for friends and family. Bugsy, Dominic's son, often spends weekends there.
Little soldier, little soldier, don't you know where you come from?
Is this the extended family? You've always had a bit of a clan around you, don't you?
Yeah, most of the time, yeah.
Some guys trying to be Elvis, look.
Oh, no.
Oh, look, Elvis Presley. Oh, hey. You go, boy.
Do you think Sean would make it an X Factor?
Yeah. Who's Sean?
Yeah.
He'd have a good go, wouldn't
he? I thought, because he's got people there as well, isn't there?
Oh, cheers. Thank you for the vote of confidence.
Yeah, there is competition.
He's right. There's some good people knocking about. He's right to say that.
Yeah, I'm joking.
Is it difficult bringing up kids these days?
It is, really. It's difficult enough when you've got
all the things that we want.
Mother and father. There's a lot of people that have one parent family. And it must be a lot difficult for them.
And all the things that we
want. Very difficult.
Can't get it. No, let's reverse that question.
No, you can't always have what you want in life, Carrie-Anne. We do our best to get what we can when we can get it. They've not been brought up to get everything they want. Even if they had the money, we can give it them.
Bugsy, how many sausages do you want?
Paddy can't work because he's ill. I can't work either. We'll do our best, you know what I mean?
Have you seen these?
Eileen's son, Sean, the young singer, has just got his GCSE results.
F in music. You should be ashamed of yourself, lad.
It's still a pass.
Do you mean it's still a pass?
It's still a pass.
An F?
A to F is a pass.
Yeah, F for fool.
Every gangster family has a single. In our family, it's me. Talk to me, tell me the signs. I sing weddings, funerals and acquittals. Mostly acquittals.
Dominic sponsors his 15-year-old nephew Sean as he embarks on a career as a club singer.
I want to be famous, top of the pops, maybe go on X Factor next year. Frank Sinatra, Gangster connections, and they didn't do him any harm.
My dreams are to be a boxer because I've always liked it since I was younger. So you wanna be a boxer in the golden ring? Can you punch like a southbound freight train? Tell me just one thing. Can you move it a word like a hummingbird? If I don't make it, be a boxer. Go for football.
Steven Robinson.
Has he died?
Dominic's protege, Aaron, is ambitious and freelances on the street as he attempts to build his own reputation as a player.
I started off as a grafter, started off working for someone else. Following a dancer, I would go round the corner, pass him it to someone, go back and we'd have bare dough. We'd have bare money in our pocket. So then, like, after about a couple of weeks went past and I thought, yeah, man, I like this, but I'm not, like, passing him all the dough because I used to pass him a big wad of change. I thought, I'm not liking it. You know, I'm not going to pass it him. Just went about all the smackheads that he had, I started giving them out, and then they met me. He had a bit of conflict saying he was going to do this, he was going to do that.
Giving his number to his shop.
So he said, right, we'll bring it. I said, you want it? You got to bring it, come and do it. So I just got my boys and that together, got a few little weapons, went round, had a scrap with him, bit his face off, end of subject. He just quit, he didn't want no anymore. Now, there's worse things going on. People was chopping and shooting people out, and he smashed one person's head in. But I took over his one patch. That's all I needed then. I would chop you in half just for a reputation. It's money and drugs and power. Because people fear us and they know what we'll do to them. I got a list of demands written on the palm of my hands. I'm on my fist and you gonna know where I stand. We live in hand to mouth. You wanna be somebody, see somebody, try and free somebody.
Greater Manchester Police have issued a warning over the plague of feral teenagers they claim are terrorising the community. Aaron is unmoved.
There's that cheap open up there.
I want my money back. I'm down here drowning in your fat. You got me on my knees praying for everything you lack. I ain't afraid of you. I'm just a victim of your fear. You cower in your tower praying that I'll disappear. I got another plan, one that requires me to stand on the stage or in the street. Don't need no microphone to beat. And if you hear this song, if you ain't dead, then sing along. Bang it from the desert, from the east of the
world.
Well, no, what's up now?
Well, they've gone off over the week. I've got to keep them out now, Tom. Do us a favour, ring them up to get this bottomed out, Tom. They've got to just fucking keep out. It's going to cost me a pub here, mate.
No, that'll go on to them, Phil.
Thanks, kiddo.
Dominic Noonan, community fixer and gangland enforcer, tries to keep the next generation in check.
They've been fighting again, yeah? It happened the other day. Fucking windows got broke again and fucking bottles. No, you're embarrassing me, I swear to God, you're embarrassing the fucking family name.
Our own daughter's embarrassing me, our own daughter.
Never mind her daughter, we've got a better name than that. Fucking idiots now, innit? That's all it's saying about you's up that end. You're just idiots.
I'm not arsed.
Not arsed? No. Well, don't drag my fucking brother's name through the mud then, yeah?
What?
Carry on.
Paul, Dominic's godson, is in trouble at school.
I was having fun, and just because I got the better of him, he started crying and went to the teacher instead of bad him.
So, what did Mrs. Roberts say to you then?
Well, I don't want you on my premises, I went home. I'll go then.
How long for?
7 days, she said. His face went dead red and started crying, and it was still red when he told the teachers that.
But I told you to stop messing about toy fighting before. Even at the house, when you start getting here, you start fucking crying.
Yeah, that's what happens.
Yeah, when I was there, it was A, B, C, right down to G. The cleverer you were, the more you were at the top, A, and the dumber you were, you're at the G.
Paul's on Z then, isn't it? Fuck, you just made up a new letter for him. Fucking hell, the bus is spending you going like that.
I don't know it's you.
I hated that school.
We the people fight for our existence. We don't claim to be perfect, but we're free. We dream our dreams alone with no resistance. Like the stars we wish to be. You know what I mean? What I just said.
But my God woke up on the wrong side of his bed, and it just don't matter now. It's little by little, gave you everything you had.
You want to be like your dad?
My dad? No, because he's done armed robberies and stuff like that, ain't he?
Do you want to go in prison?
No, because they spit in your drinks and... How do you know they could piss in your drink? You don't know. Spit in your food, then mix it all up.
Your dad's been in 24 years as well.
No, but he's been eating all sorts.
Probably. I'd do it to get one of my mates out of trouble. I'd go in prison for that.
I'd go in prison for my family.
Yeah, so would I, but I wouldn't go and do something off my own back.
For myself.
Like an armed robber, for example.
I couldn't do that, man.
I could get you put in prison.
I'd prefer to get other people to do it for me. If you think about it.
Don't wanna die anyway. Don't wanna die young.
Neither do I.
Probably get killed.
And I do.
So.
Yo. Freaking.
So I'm gonna be a singer, become a millionaire with me voice, and then I'm gonna buy up all the pubs and clubs in Manchester, and then I'm gonna design my own train, design my own plane, buy a pink Hummer, a Porsche 911. A Range Rover and my very own boat. Abramovich, like Abramovich, with his big fucking Russian yacht.
Dominic has serious family issues. His brother Desmond, a hitman and enforcer, is now hooked on crack cocaine. He's out of control and upsetting other underworld figures in the city.
Not seen him, he's probably on the rock somewhere.
he's disappeared. He comes out when he's got no money. And then manages to get some.
Has he just lost on the crack there, is he then?
Totally gone off the rails. He's on drugs. It's a shame, really. He has such a big name. And his name's shit.
At the end of the day, it's a dangerous drug to mess around with. People say, oh, you should help him. You can't. They've got to say it themselves. They've got to say, that's it, I'm fucking finished. And he keeps telling me, I'm off it. I've been off it now 5-6 weeks. But he hasn't. He's a fucking liar. He's always lying. They're always born liars, them kind of people.
Dominic has his own troubles. He and six other co-defendants have been accused of kidnapping and brutally torturing an underworld figure for a ransom of £500,000.
Oh, Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Cinnamon, where you gonna run to?
Once again, another Noonan trial and no witnesses.
Just lucky, aren't we? Just lucky people.
It's not just one witness, I understand. It's seven or eight. Eight.
Eight witnesses have decided to leave the country. All of them have left the country. That has been confirmed by the courts. They must have had a tour package. They must have got a cheap deal. The more gold, the cheaper it is, isn't it?
Dominic's co-defendants arrive at court. The judge was to hear that the victim was left with dozens of stab wounds, was tortured with boiling water, and had cigarette burns all over his body. While Dominic's case grinds on, the police inevitably turn their attention to his young associate, Aaron.
Close your back window. Your back door. We don't like the police. Open the door. Mike! Dickhead, Mike! Yeah. Come, put it up. Yo, Volvo, you dickhead.
And he's still there? Oh, he's coming out to wind them up then.
Paul's getting nicked.
As the police depart, the young guns contemplate life with Dominic behind bars.
But the difference is with Dom, he's got no one to work his back. Whereas I've got all my rafters and all these.
He's only got his family, you know what I mean? We've got boys and family.
Straight away, Dom goes down, I will take over at the end of the day, it'd be mine. Everything's been mine.
Yeah, if you wanted it,
Aaron's ambition to take over Dominic's territory looks more probable as the absent witnesses in Dominic's kidnapping and torture trial are brought to court by the police.
The case is against me is that I'm in possession of a telephone which can be linked to the persons who have abducted somebody. But so what, a phone? So that you could have ended up with that phone. It's like me now giving you the phone. And then a week later you're arrested and you've got to explain where's it come from. Now they've asked for police protection on the jury. I mean, what's all that about? What are they trying to say, that we're going to intimidate the jury?
Hello?
No, Paddy, it's not going on. I'm on trial at the moment. I'm at court every day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I'm on a 6-week trial, yeah? So I've got to deal with it when I can get back in time when the case gets adjourned. Paddy, I'm only doing my best for you, Paddy. At least you got a big cheque to come, haven't you, for Christmas?
Paddy, I'm under a lot of stress, yeah? All right, then. Not as much as me, Paddy. You're not expecting 20 years next week, are you? Hey, right, then.
Fucking prick.
The jury in Dominic's torture and kidnapping trial are shortly to be sent out to reach their verdicts. The evidence implicating him in the brutal events appears compelling, but Dominic has an experienced legal team and remains defiantly optimistic.
Got them fucking dogs up. Get this hairy fucking monster out, man.
How did your barrister sum up for you?
Summed up very well. I was fairly surprised because he convinced me that I wasn't there. That's how good he was.
Do you think he convinced the jury you weren't there?
You've only got to put doubt in one mind.
Dominic Noonan is facing 20 years in jail if convicted. He's accused of leading a gang of men to kidnap and torture another underworld figure for £500,000 ransom. Three police forces and the National Crime Squad worked on the case. Sensationally, the public gallery is closed after concerns that Desmond Noonan, Dominic's brother, is intimidating the jury, a crime he has previously been convicted of. After 2 days of discussion, the jury returned to find five of Dominic's gang guilty, but they could not decide on the fate of the crime boss.
You never know with the juries. Like I said, they find guilty people innocent and innocent people guilty.
Finally, after a week of deliberations, the jury decide on Dominic Noonan's future.
Another victory, another Noonan set off, and I'm coming home.
I said to them cops when I left that courtroom, walked right up to him in the box, I said, you went for me, you lost, you're a fucking rat. Jury. I want to know where the payment is. Hello?
In less than a year, Dominic Noonan has now walked free from two major trials, costing over £5 million. He and his brother Desi remain the chief targets of Manchester police and are now under constant surveillance.
Excuse me?
Yes, sir.
Can you go on? Can I have a bottle of Bex, please?
That's what I'm saying.
Another escape from the jaws of justice reinforced the Noonan's apparent invincibility.
We're not dinosaurs and we'll never be extinct. Nah, 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 nah. It's not we have luck, it's just the jury believes that we're innocent people.
Will someone ever take a Noonan in Manchester?
I hope so. I hope it's me first. I'm fucking fed up. I'm fucking fed up and I've got no money. I've got a pot to piss in, got a shitty car, married, kids, mortgage, fed up. If you know anyone thinking of setting the Noonans out, can you meet me first, please? Please do it as quickly as possible. In fact, I'll even come to you if I have to. Just give us a phone call, I'll meet you anywhere you want, and make sure it's behind the back of the ear and it's fucking clean. And don't let me linger, for fuck's sake. I'm a whinging bastard. But please meet me the first. But in the meantime, you want to set Dominic before me, then you can have him. You can't take any Noonans. We've not done anything to be took out, have we? No one wants to hurt us at the end of the day. And if they did, by God, there'd be some fireworks.
Would there?
Oh, I've got a bigger army than the police. We've got more guns than the police, silly bastards. I'm down to 25 murders. Well, a load of bollocks, innit?
24, wasn't it, you done?
No, I didn't do 24. And, what do you call
it? How many was it alleged you did?
Oh, for loads. To police, they're betting 20, 30. I'm behind most of the murders in Manchester.
And how are you?
No.
He's a good Catholic, believes in life.
I'm a Catholic. I don't believe in life for the life. I don't believe in taking life.
Within weeks of the trial, Desmond Noonan was attacked and stabbed on the streets of northwest Manchester.
Dominic, tell me what happened.
I just got a phone call of Sanders saying that he's just been stabbed in the last 10, 15 minutes of that. So he's just been stabbed, and she had a phone call of him saying he was dying in the street. And she told me, she said he's lying on the floor now, he's got something, you know. I don't know what to do.
Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. He's not going to die, is he?
No, 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 no. Fucking trouble if he does. A lot of trouble if he does. I think so, his lemon's product, blue lighting. Check it, Chris.
I seen two ambulances pulling up a few seconds behind each other. The first one stopped. And then as he opened the door, I just saw a man laying on there. I couldn't see his face. I didn't think that was Desi at first. Just then I saw all the police surrounding that ambulance. Then I said to the copper, is that Desi Noonan? He went, yeah, why?
I say he's my brother.
They started pumping on him. The doctors got in there, started pressing on him and that. I was just seeing that he was dead. I could see that he was dead. His stomach had swollen up. It looked like... he was a big lad anyway, but he looked twice the size. And then... afterwards, when I got told that he bled inside, I realised then why he'd swollen up. Because all the blood stayed inside, it didn't go anywhere.
Manchester's number one hit music station.
Desmond Newman had boasted he was untouchable and laughed when asked about his involvement in gangland killings in Manchester.
This is the spot where the 45-year-old was stabbed twice. Once in the stomach,
to Merseybank Avenue in Charlton, where they found Desmond Noonan lying with two stab wounds to his abdomen.
In the stomach near his home in Charlton, just days before he was due to feature in a fly-in-the-wall documentary.
Tonight, police said there'd be a large number of extra patrols in the Charlton area over the next few days to reassure members of the community.
I went to the scene where it happened. Within minutes, I found out who'd done it. His history. He's finished. He knows he's finished. That's just life.
I was in shock. I mean, I was still... I'd had a beer the night before and I was still feeling the beer, and as soon as I got told, it was like sober straight away. Phoned Dom, just said, Dom, said I feel about your loss and that. There's nothing much you could say, really. You don't know what to say when things like that happen, but...
It's been massive for 3 months. No doubt about that.
No doubt about that. Obviously, if Damien's was big and dead...
People I've never even met not turning up.
With people being killed like Desi, now, it makes you realise if such a big guy was killed and if he was killed, it makes you think, yo, well, I could be next.
If someone that big can get took away like that, we can get took away a lot, hell of a lot quicker.
We're like where he started, we're at the beginning, we're in the prime, you know what I mean? We're just up and coming. Eventually, we might be like him, we might be bigger than him, might be nowhere near him, might be dead.
They're the original ones, they're where we've got it from, they're who we've watched and thought, we could do that, we'll try that, if they can do it, we can do it. Anyone can do it. You've got a set of balls, yeah, and you've got it.
What you've got to understand is when Desert and all these gangsters that you call gangsters, when they was kids, yeah, they had holes in their roofs, they didn't have no food, or they did what they did to survive. We do it for a rush.
We do it for the adrenaline, the actual rush of taking someone else's things off him. Bam, as easy as that.
I say we do about 30 robberies and we'll get caught for one. And you're talking like at least 10 grand each robbery.
Did anyone ever teach you the difference in right and wrong?
No. No one teaches us how to read, never mind right and wrong. We can't read, we can't write. We can't have money, no. Right, we're going grafting and then what? You'll see this face on Crime Watch UK.
Desi Noonan had a number of convictions for serious criminal offences. But the motive for his killing remains unclear. What seemed initially to have been a gangland-style execution now looks increasingly likely to have been a stabbing after a row.
I wish I was in a land of cotton. Old times they are not forgotten. Look away, look away. Look away, Dixieland.
Dominic phoned me the Friday night, Saturday morning at 7:45. And he said, Eileen, it's Dominic, I've got some bad news for you. He said, our Desi found dead last night. Me just waking up, I just said, you're joking. He went, no, I'm not joking. I said, I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. Just because I just woke up, you know. And woke Paddy up and told Paddy.
So hush, little baby, don't you cry. You know your daddy's
bound to die. No, my trials, Lord, will soon be over.
As head of the family, Dominic is responsible for the funeral arrangements.
Now, Dominic, the casket that you've chosen, this is the one here.
Right.
It's called a Pieta, the Last Supper coffin. It's got all the bronze handles, corner pieces.
They're the best ones you got.
You can't get anything better. Your lads are going to carry the coffin to the hearse.
Yeah, my lads will be carrying it.
Because he's quite a big man.
Yeah.
He's quite a big man. He's dead such them and move them.
Dominic, as head of the family, takes centre stage, but his preparations are interrupted by a death threat.
What's that?
Did a guy get murdered yesterday? Well, I believe he's been shot dead yesterday. Yeah, good friend of ours. Well, I received a threatening letter today saying that's our next, because there's the old money. I've doubled all my guards and I've doubled my fucking vests.
How many's allowed in the car?
Six in the back.
Yeah.
We can get an extra person in the front.
Yeah, I want a guard to go in each car.
One black ribbon winding through the streets that you once knew. We process our footsteps trapped in time with some black-hearted tune. To the fields most tear-stained, build a palace of our grave.
Motorways, schools and businesses have closed for the day out of respect and safety.
An investigation is underway into why two Manchester high schools decided to close during the funeral of a self-confessed gangster.
The numbers here have been swelled by a controversial decision which has angered many parents.
It's nothing to do with the children. They should let the kids carry on to school. It's only a fella that died.
Some estimates have suggested that up to 3,000 people would arrive. Some estimates suggested that up to 3,000 people would attend this funeral. In fact, the figures.
Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our brother Desmond. The sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother forever. We ask this through Christ. Our Lord.
A friend to the family sends a clear message to the murderer during the Requiem Mass.
But notwithstanding where we are, I will say this. For me, forgive me, fathers. For me, there is no forgiveness for the perpetrator. and there is no forgetting for the perpetrator. Wherever he or they may ever reside, that is my position.
For the Noonans, the funeral is a chance to mourn and a chance to demonstrate their strength. Desmond left behind a wife, ex-wife and four children. His relations have travelled from Ireland, the US and Holland to pay their respects. Bugsy, Paul and Sean, the next generation, are at the forefront of the occasion. The cortege, under constant police supervision and covert observation, march through northwest Manchester.
In a minute, I want you to get up there, take the lads in the blues and the yellows, and don't let no one up that path. Say only immediate family around the grave first, the rest come in.
God of holiness and power, accept our prayers in behalf of your servant Desmond. Do not count his deeds against him, for in his heart he desired to do your will. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I say it clear, I state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I've traveled each and every highway. Oh, more, much more than this, I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not. To see the words he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows and did it my way.
Struggling with the occasion, Paul seeks comfort from his godfather Dominic.
Oh,
has been arrested and is now being questioned by police.
Two people have been charged in connection with Desi Noonan's death.
A 41-year-old Manchester man has been charged with Desmond Noonan's murder.
Bath time. And it's the first bath I've had. Look at them, they're like a drowning rats trying to get out.
Shut up.
Come on. Careful what you film here, I don't want the RSPCA on my case. Put that one in the microwave for 30 seconds. One's missing.
Since the funeral, Paul has been spending less and less time with his godfather, Dominic.
The court has been hearing how Mr. Noonan was allegedly killed by his drug supplier.
The court heard that on the night of March 18th, Desi Noonan had been drinking heavily. He'd then gone out in search of cocaine. An hour later, he was dead. A drug dealer who stabbed a Manchester criminal to death has been jailed for at least 15 years.
Today, jailed for life with a minimum of 15 years behind bars.
Former bouncer Derek McDuffus killed Des after years of bad blood between them.
Derek McDuffus was convicted of the murder of Desmond Noonan and sentenced to 18 years. Within hours of arriving at Strangeways Prison, he was brutally assaulted. After weeks in the hospital wing, he has now been moved to an undisclosed location.
Someone whacks him, they whack him. He's got a fuck all to do with me, but good luck to him anyway. The amounts of people that have come up and told me how much they want to kill him.
Nothing, there's been enough killing.
It's only just begun. It's only just begun.
Just 3 months after Dominic was acquitted of the kidnap and torture charges, he's been arrested again, this time on firearms charges.
Good evening, I'm Ian Kenyon. Three men from Manchester have been charged with firearms offences after they were stopped by police in Durham. A spokesman for Durham Police said they were arrested after ammunition and a gun were recovered from a Jaguar car on the 8167 in Darlington. Noonan was charged under his deed poll acquired name, Lackley Quad Point.
This is my undercover unit.
He was arrested in the company of his young associates, 17-year-old Adam Walsh and 19-year-old Aaron Berry. The arrest followed a long-term surveillance operation by Greater Manchester Police. Unusually for Dominic, he has not been granted bail. Whilst awaiting trial, he has been designated one of the country's most dangerous prisoners and has been placed in the high security wing of Wakefield Prison.
Dominic, what happened with the arrest? Tell me.
I've gone up there on the fucking Sunday. I was under surveillance when they left me house in the morning at 8:30. They said they've had me under surveillance for months. They had police saying they saw us get out of the car, lift the bonnet up.
And what kind of gun was it, Dominic?
Just a normal revolver with five bullets found in the bonnet area, hidden inside the fucking batching compartment.
Well, how are conditions in the prison for you?
Well, I'm on a unit, high risk, fucking, not had one single visit yet, Donald. You keep knocking people fucking back. They won't let me have any visits, and they just stitching me up.
Bugsy is receiving bereavement counselling following the death of his uncle Desmond, a key male role model in his life. His father, Dominic, is now back in jail, as he has been for most of Bugsy's 11 years.
Well, I love him, of course, because he's my dad, and that's it, really, because I love him, and that's it.
No matter what he does.
No matter what he does. He's still gonna be there for me.
Bugsy, B-U-G-S-Y, Bugsy. Told his mum to get his passport done and everything.
So
I'm gonna fuck off. You know what, when I go, I'm not bringing him back. He's not coming back. I'm being brought up in this fucking shithole.
In all your time, how long have you spent with him?
Say 2 years, because I've done fucking 6 months on remand on the last one, didn't it?
2 years in, out of 11 years. Suspended clear in the sky. The words that we sing.
let there be love. Let there be love.
Get in there and told me to cut the bottom off with the tomato ketchup on, will you too?
Sorry.
Any plans for when Dominic gets out of jail?
He's taking him on holiday.
Carry on.
Where's he going to take you?
Anywhere where I want.
You fancy doing him on holiday, Bugs?
Might be going to Jamaica.
Jamaica?
Jamaica.
Put me in your suitcase.
What?
Put me in your suitcase.
You're in a suitcase.
Don't you start, you.
I want my family to be careful and don't tell people what they're doing because it's their business and, as you know, you might say it to the wrong person and they might grass you up to the police and get you arrested.
Dominic Noonan and his two associates are charged with possession of a 9mm converted revolver and 5 rounds of ammunition. All on that day. Unprecedented security arrangements are put in place to bring the Manchester crime lord to court. The courthouse is surrounded by 23 armed guards after police receive intelligence that Dominic Noonan may be orchestrating an escape attempt. Bugsy, too young to attend, goes paintballing with friends instead.
All right, you need to listen to this, okay? These paintballs are extra hard today. I'm sure you're going to be cold, so you're going to be in lots of pain, I'm sorry to say. I don't want to see anyone shooting dead people.
The prosecution case against Dominic and his associates is strong. A long-term police surveillance operation claims to have filmed the three placing a gun inside the car. Manchester police are quietly confident that Dominic Noonan will not escape British justice this time. After 4 days of legal argument, two of Dominic's co-defendants, Aaron Berry and Adam Walsh, plead guilty.
Well, Dominic, maybe they pleaded guilty because they are guilty. Are you guilty?
Would I say I'm guilty on the phone?
No.
Well, don't ask a stupid question.
After a 4-day trial, the jury returned their verdict in just 15 minutes.
Bradley Fodd Boy of Beacom Street in Manchester was found guilty of possessing a firearm and ammunition without a license.
The judge described Dominic Noonan as a dangerous man and sentenced him to 16 and a half years in jail.
What do you think a gangster is?
But they go around killing people. But not for no reason, for a reason, it has to be for a reason. Like, say, if they owed them money or something like that.
With remission, time served, and concurrent sentencing, Dominic Noonan will serve just 3 years and 9 months in prison.
I can't help it, can I? He's a gangster, he's a gangster. And that's it, really.
Thank you.
Funny how time's passed, soon as here, moment after moment, and year after year. I'm from a town by the estuary, where the arse of the river meets the mouth of the sea. And that town's a shithole, and everyone leaves, sunk down in the river, or caught by the breeze, crossed out.